Hello guys, Mukas here. Just wanted to react on what happened recently with the Palisade 2 community and the recent updates and the state of the game in general, because it's been a long time that I haven't talked about this. And there was some events recently that pushed me like to react. For example, the outfit wars and how it went. From a long time ago, I already said that I wasn't interested in the format. I'm gonna explain now why, and maybe you'll understand me when I say that I'm not interested in playing in it. It's honestly I'm super proud in general of what Rogue Planet Games are doing. The escalation update, the fact that they implemented outfit wars, many updates went good. The game is not that buggy. You don't crash that much, except a few things. But the state of the game in general, except some connection issues for some servers like Soltec, etc. Whenever I play the game, I'm really having a blast. The only thing that's missing, honestly, especially in low pop hours, is population. Sometimes the population is too low for the whole continent to open. But in prime time, usually, I think the game is really epic. And the outfit wars is for me is just an epic phenomenon. But I wanted to explain why I'm not that. I could be interested in it more, but what really annoys me is that it's very hard to spectate this game. Like even if there is nice matches with very epic players that are super skilled, that have crazy tactics, it's almost impossible for the casters to see what's happening, because the Vicar said, like the worst observer camera in gaming spectating a three-way fight. Like the casters are running almost blind. Like they don't know who they're watching, they don't hear their comms, and for us watching from the outside, it gets boring very fast. Like little soldiers running on the field, little vehicles, tanks running around, but you don't see the skill, you don't see trick shots, you don't see 360 Desi slingshot and something. you don't see the skill of the players. You have to. You have to rely on the caster telling you what's happening, and you know that they cannot see much of what's happening. So the observer camera in Planetside 2 is really bad for casting. It's like it's not really a camera, it's a vehicle. It's an invisible vehicle. You can bump on people, you can collide with people and vehicles. You can zoom to a certain extent. You cannot auto-follow someone, you have to follow them manually, which can be very hard when you're following infantry or following vehicles. It's very hard to showcase what's happening, except when you want to do cinematic shots or something like that, or maybe a machinima. But casting a match where there is individual stories, like the outfit wars is about the outfits. The outfits are about the players that are in the outfits, and when the casters are looking at this from the outside, you cannot say what are the tactics they're using, and you cannot hear the tension in their voices, and you cannot see their skill. So I don't know, for me there is almost no point to watching it, but playing it seems actually really fun to play. Like the map looks cool. I would love to play this map on the live servers, like with a lot of population and people that can do whatever they want. I like this map because people can build bases almost anywhere. So I found this mechanic very interesting, and I'm curious to see it on live and how the players are going to interact with this on live. So it looks really fun to play, like when you're in it. But when you're spectating, you have to rely on the casters, and sometimes and it gets very hard for them. Like, honestly, I empathize. Like it's very hard to commentate on the action when you don't know, you don't hear the comms, and you don't see the individual skill. So for me, it's not that interesting. So I was focused on other things, and this event, like. Actually, the positive things that this event brought for me is that it made me aware of the outfits in Planetside 2, and I think the outfits is the blood of Planetside 2, the outfit, and especially the leaders, people who are squad leading, are the real blood of the game. So at least it made me aware of these people, and yes, it created some rivalry and some drama, but honestly, it's not that important. I said to dig first world problems, don't really care about this. But I still want to really congratulate Rogue Planet Game for what they are doing. They are trying to create an event that can bring the community together, and it's not easy because Planetside 2 is very unique, and they have a small dev team. So I'm very I'm trying to be comprehensive of their situation. What I would say about Outfit Wars, I would love to play the map on live. The thing that prevents me from playing it is I don't want to register to play on a certain time, on a certain date with certain people. I just want to play on the map and see how it plays. That's it. And if the observer cam was much better, if you could spectate here the comms of the players you're following, this would be much more interesting. And of course, the fact that it's a 1v1v1 makes it very hard to call it competitive, because it's like built in the game that there's going to be collusion. Like the squad leaders are like one Discord away from talking to each other and colluding for whatever reason. So I'm not going to blame the players for them. I'm blaming the game. It's a three-way fight. And I think to make it really competitive and to know really which one is the best outfit, 1v1 would be the best choice. I don't know for the rest of the details, but 1v1v1 is a flawed, like, from the beginning. If you wanna do competition and to have like to have a winner at the end, and if there is stakes, I think it's much more simple to make it 1v1. And I don't even think they should change the map. They could just leave it like that. It actually looks like a StarCraft map. One faction on top, one faction below, left or right. And just let them fight, see which one captures the continent. And please improve the observer cam to make it easier for us to watch and to make it easier on the casters. One thing that I really like about this event is that it showcases the team play of the outfits, and especially when they are using all the war assets, all the vehicles, the air, the ground, the Colossus, the Citadel shield, the orbital strikes, and the infantry at the same time. This is actually cool to watch and cool to witness, and it can be interesting to see how it's going to impact after that the live play. So these were my thoughts on Outfit Wars and how it could be improved and how it would make it more interesting for people who like to watch competitive events. Big props to all the casters that have been spectating the match and casting all the match, especially Archie, because he did a huge job to get at all these matches, commentate on them all, and then after that interview, I think all the squad leaders and a lot of the players. It's a lot of work, so I want to give him props. I also want to give props to Dig, because he's been doing like a breakdown videos of what happened with the drama exactly. It helped me understand what happened. So thank you to these two guys for their work and their contribution. Check them out. They're really underrated, especially Dig. Right now, what interests me the most in Blindside 2 and the upcoming patches is simply a new map. People know like every inch of every corner, and it start getting old. Like after 9 years old to play on the same maps over and over again, it should be interesting to have a new map with an interesting concept. Like maybe like it's a forest map or a map with a lot of bridges, a lot of heights. Anything that would make it interesting, to make it really to refresh it and to make the players able to exploit the assets of Blindside 2 in a different way. I'm also really pissed that they don't take more advantage of the construction system on the live games on Indar, Esamir, etc. The no construction zones are still huge, and they prevent you from building in most places. When I think it could make the landscape really interesting if people could build bases and spawn points next to the vanilla bases. Imagine if you could build a fortress right next to the crown, like at south of the crown, you manage to build a huge fortress. On the attacker side, it's going to make it much easier for you to set up spawns at the crown, and it's going to create fights in the underused part of the terrain. So please, Rogue Planet Games, take more advantage of the construction system. I honestly think that there is almost all the elements in the game, Planetside 2, for it to make it really epic, and there is only a few tweaks that they could do to make a huge difference. For example, make the construction system more impactful. One concept that I also find very interesting in one of Dig's video, he was doing a breakdown on the Outfit Wars and how Rogue Planet Games could help promote its game. And he talked about a concept called the Circle of Love, where the Rogue Planet Games give credits, give love, give rewards to the people who help the game. And who are the people who help the game? These are mostly the squad leaders, the platoon leaders, the content creators that are taking time out of their day to teach new players or bring new players to the game or just entertain the existing community. So I think by Rogue Planet Games rewarding its content creators, squad leaders and platoon leaders more, it will create a circle of love where these content creators, squad leaders, etc. are going to be motivated to create more content I got a motivated to squad lead more, platoon lead more. And when we have a motivated squad leader, this is one of the best way to retain a new player or even an intermediate player that's very casual. When you randomly find a good squad with good direction, with an experienced squad leader that is having fun, it makes the game very addictive. The problem is the burnout, is that many of the squad leaders get tired. It's like exhausting to lead squad and talk constantly and deal with the people that don't obey orders, deal with trolls, sometimes stream snipers. Like, you have to deal with all that, spend your energy, squad leading, platoon leading. It doesn't even guarantee your victory. You're just making a server for the whole squad and the game in general. And you get almost no reward for it, except with the mission system. You can select some missions where you platoon lead and you get experience, sometimes weapons. But these kinds of rewards are not that interesting and is not what experienced players are looking for as reward. Experienced players want like some recognition, like to have like their name somewhere for having led that many people for that good or for being as recommended. This is how I think RPG could pimp the Sanctuary. They could put screens everywhere talking about the big achievements of the players in PlanetSide 2. People who deploy a lot of spawns, people who squad lead a lot, people who create content that are specialized. Like, imagine a big screen, like there was a post on Reddit like that, where there was a big screen in the middle of the Sanctuary with Archie's face shoutcasting or doing something. This would be really cool to see your face or your name in the game you love in the Sanctuary, and everyone else can see it. Some other rewards could be cosmetics, or maybe just Daybreak cash for squad leaders that are doing an amazing job. Good squad leaders, good platoon leaders are literally working for Rogue Planet Games for free. So a little bit of recognition for the best ones would be really nice. Big outfits actually shape the story of PlanetSide 2. Like, we all heard of P-Way because of their amazing organization. People heard of my outfit because of my drama and because I used to kick serious ass. What I'm saying is that PlanetSide 2 has some amazing content creators that are doing incredible work, and they barely get any recognition from PlanetSide 2 or from the developers. And like Dig said, I think the devs could create some kind of circle of love where they give credits to the creators, squad leaders, etc. And then these squad leaders, creators, give love to the community and create content, squad lead even more. And this will at the end impact the retention of the new players that are joining these open squads, joining these open platoons, where they hear people having a lot of fun. Personally, I think the squad voice chat and platoon voice chat is one of the biggest assets to the game. When you log in, honestly, I found it fascinating. I'm from Morocco, Africa, and when I play on Emerald, I just join a random squad and I hear Americans talking. It's really special for me. Like, it's not every day in Morocco that you hear Americans talking about anything. Like, just it's very interesting for me, guys. It's English. I learned English just by playing the game and hearing people talk about it. And it's not my first language at all. And I still find it fascinating that you can join a squad where people talk Spanish, join a squad where people talk German, join a squad just for Russians. I find this really fascinating. This is, in my opinion, one of the biggest assets to the game, and it's a big part of all MMO games. Yes, I think the tutorial should be changed. It's very limited, and I've seen it bore people and make them quit the game just because the tutorial sucks. But I think what would make a bigger difference is give recognition to the squad leaders, content creators, streamers, so they double down on the content, double down on the squad leading, and it's a circle that only goes up. This is why I think it's such a great idea by Dig. This is my opinion on the state of the game. It's still extremely enjoyable to play. Gunplay feels great. Battles are epic in high graphics. You can customize your voice pack to get the sounds you want when you get kills. So I still think PlanetSide 2 is one of the best games out there if you like FPS games. Actually, I have a hard time going back to other games where it's like 5v5, 1v1, 2v2. I'm like, this is too small. I feel claustrophobic. So until another MMO FPS comes out, PlanetSide 2 is my favorite game. We'll see how Battlefield 6 is gonna be. They say that it's gonna have massive scale also. I honestly enjoy to see the progression in this game because I started with PlanetSide 2 at launch in 2012. And the game was like radically different, like the resources, the weapons, the graphics, and especially the computers that people were having at the time. I upgraded my computer maybe 3 times since the launch of the game, and I upgraded my computer mostly for that, for PlanetSide 2. Right now, I think we're arriving at a time where the game is much more approachable for gamers, Now most PC gamers can run the game flawlessly in low or medium graphics. So I'm not giving up on the marketing of PlanetSide 2. More people every day can actually play the game without frame drops. And it's still the only MMOFPS out there. And that starts to be very refined in some ways. Some small details I really like the fact that you can pull vehicles from the map screen. It used to be very annoying before that when you had to go to the vehicle terminal. Now you can pull them from the map screen. At some point this ability was bugged. You could double pull a lightning and waste your resources. It has been fixed. Now we can pull war assets in the middle of the battlefield, like an orbital strike, a citadel shield, drop thunders from the sky, and it makes for some very interesting plays for teams. And this is why I keep my faith with this game, and I wish it all the success. If you want to keep the game alive, support the creators, support the developers, give your feedback, play, comment on videos to make them pop on YouTube. And that's it, guys. Let me know what you think about the state of the game. I would love to know. Have a good day. Stay epic. Bye bye.
Vraiment, ouais, c'est ce qu'on m'a dit, qu'ils étaient pas gentils.
Ouais, mec, check. Je suis à dire Situational Awareness à ça, Abby.
Entraînement d'utilisateur Daybreak, c'est quoi ça, pour pas ce Daybreak Zippy là? C'est quoi ce truc? C'est quoi avec Daybreak là? Pourquoi il me demande de mémoriser mes noms? Rock and
roll! It's time to kick ass and chew bubble gum. Ah non, je suis mort! And I'm all
out of gum. Ok, achète-toi un micro et Zippy.
Venez me soigner. Ah, on m'a résurrecté, monsieur. Je suis content, monsieur.
Désolmex 302.
Vas-y, monsieur, je te couvre, je te couvre. Parce que tu es un peu faible. La sauce. Non. Tu vas mûrir.
Vous êtes sur quoi? Sur Miller là ou sur Emerald?
Miller, ça va être Miller. Mec, spawn sur le Sandy, mec, il va bientôt crever là.